Hi, I'm Jordy from the Cinecom YouTube channel, and in collaboration with Adobe, we made a brand new short film called The Game of Life. It's about a researcher who's going to use the neural network for his project, but actually he's not allowed to do that. So, in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can create your own login screen inside Adobe After Effects, and we're going to use the new properties panel for that. Now, I have a stock clip of this network kind of thing, which I'll use for the background, and you can find such video assets on Adobe Stock. On top of that, I'll draw a rectangle shape. Now, before, if you wanted to change any settings, we had to expand the layers of that shape and look for the properties we need. That's different now. If you go to the menu on top, you'll find properties in here, and I suggest you dock that panel somewhere as you'll be using it a lot. Now, it will show the properties of any layer that I select. You can kind of see it as the effects controls in Premiere Pro, so it's much easier now and faster to make adjustments. And for shape layers, you'll see some more properties, like the different layers within a shape. We can select those and make specific changes. I'm going to make sure that my rectangle has a white fill color and no border. And let's also animate that shape layer so that it opens up. Of course, you want to use the timeline for that. And to easily jump to that scale property, you can just double-click on it. Alright, so I'm going to animate the rectangle to make it go open and, of course, ease those keyframes for smooth animations. What I've got next is a logo. Again, an Adobe Stock asset. On the right side, we're going to make the logo input, create two text layers for the username and one for the password. Now, to align them better, you can make use of the guidelines. The input boxes are going to be shapes again. We'll take the rounded rectangle tool. After I've created one input box, I'm going to duplicate it by pressing Command D on my keyboard. And for the Windows users, that's going to be Control D. Drag it down under the password label. And I'm going to do that one more time for the submit button. Now, all of these fields right here sit under one shape layer. So in the properties panel, we can select both the input fields and change the stroke, fill color, and everything at the same time. Now, when we start typing our username, we'll highlight that input box by making the stroke a little bit wider. So I'm going to animate the stroke width for the username input first, and then for the password field as well. Now, the login button can be a little bit smaller in size, which again, we can do from the properties panel. I'm also going to give it a different fill color and make sure that the stroke is zero. Also, let's add a text in there that says login, and make sure to change the size of the button to make it fit with that text. Alright, I'm gonna type Robert's name in the input field, who is the protagonist of the short film, and also in the password field. Now, the password should, of course, be these dots or asterisks. To animate a typing effect, you want to expand the text fields and click on Animate and choose Opacity. The opacity can be zero, hiding the text, but if we expand the range selector, we can make it reveal itself. So that's the property that will animate from 0 to 100. Now, the only thing that kind of bothers me now is that the letters fade in. And that's not how typing works, of course. So open up the advanced settings from the range selector and get rid of the smoothness. Looking good. Now, I'm going to do the same thing for the password field, which is going to give you the typing effect for both fields. Now, at the moment that we start typing in the password field, the login button should become active. So create a keyframe for the fill color. Go forward one or a couple of frames and change it to something more vibrant. Blue really works well in this case. Now, the last step is to animate the click button. I'm just gonna keyframe the scale to create this click animation. Now, when you play back the interface animation, we shouldn't see the UI elements in the beginning yet. I'm simply going to select all of those layers and use the properties panel to animate the opacity from 0 to 100. And that's it! Now let's render the video out and put it on a display in your film set. The talent does not have to worry about typing, they can just use a dummy keyboard and your animation will always have the correct timing. So I really hope that you learned something new today, and if you haven't seen my short film yet, definitely go check out the link in the description down below. You'll also find a playlist with more tutorial videos about this short. So thank you so much for watching, and as always, stay creative.